And big breakthrough in Mysuru gang rape case. After 4 days of investigation, Mysuru police has now arrested four accused. Four people have been arrested from outside Karnataka. Now these accused will be brought to Mysuru and produced in court. Neha Hebale is with us to give more details. Neha, over to you. Who are these four people and tell us about the details as far as arrests are concerned.
Well, Gauri, this is in fact, you know, the first on Mirror Now. We've got the first confirmation that four people, in fact, have been arrested by the Mysuru police over here with regard to this very, brutal gang rape. We understand that yesterday teams of police over here were formed and they were, in fact, sent to both Kerala as well as Tamil Nadu and Bengaluru as well. The police was, in fact, roped in over there. And now what we're picking up in the latest is that about four people, you know, who had, in fact, actually fled to one of the neighbouring states has, you know, in fact, been arrested now. The team of police that was sent there actually was sent after technical evidence as well as electronic evidence was verified. Their whereabouts were, in fact, you know, tracked, of course, using the evidence that was collected, the active SIM cards that the police had picked up from the crime scene during the time of the crime. That was actually matched again later with the, evidence that they collected from the whereabouts of where these alcohol bottles were purchased as well. And further following up on that lead now, when teams were sent to neighbouring states of both Kerala as well as Tamil Nadu, they have managed to nab those four people. They are being brought back to Mysuru city now. They will in fact be produced in the court, after which they will be grilled thoroughly is what we are picking up. But this is in fact, you know, the first arrest that's actually being made in this case, Gauri. Very important to remember over here that it was on Tuesday, 4 days ago, that this woman and her friend were in fact, you know, a witness or subject to this horrific incident where she was gang raped and her friend was beaten up brutally. Imperative over here, what has actually helped the police nab, in fact, you know, the accused right now is the statement that was given by this friend over here who was actually beaten about basic details. That's where the police started their investigation when they confirmed that, one of the people over here who was involved in this crime was speaking in Tamil. That is the first clue that the police picked up. Following up on that, they actually zeroed in on all of the Tamil Nadu SIM cards and all of the Kerala SIM cards as well. And basis that, they've then matched that again with the possible, you know, on the outskirts of Karnataka, Tamil Nadu. Yesterday, searches were going on in Attibele as well, which is on the Karnataka, Tamil Nadu border. So even on that border as well, searches were conducted. And basis that now they have, in fact, you know, managed to go and arrest four people, Gauri.
Right. Also, Neha, we have to understand and we have to highlight this fact also that this particular case, we have been covering all aspects of it right from day one. And you have been closely and minutely basically observing every development which is happening. If we talk about government's response and police's response in this case, we have been seeing that after this piled up pressure, the CM himself and the Home Minister himself started taking personal interest in this case and the probe. And finally, is it because of that pressure that we are seeing some movement now?
Well, Gauri, what's important for us to remember is that, you know, yes, while, there have been allegations against the police of slacking in this case initially and not making much progress, the kind of statements that had come in both from the Home Minister as well as from the other ministers who backed him up was definitely uncalled for. The Home Minister, in fact, even on the day, of course, this incident, on the very next day, had said that had blamed the victims for having travelled to that spot, following up by which, you know, there were many MLAs, there were another two ministers as well who came out in support of him and said there was nothing wrong with what he had said. But another reason now, of course, you know, why the DGP himself, Praveen Sood, had to personally come down and supervise this case was Gauri. In fact, he's also been the commissioner of Mysuru City, you know, in the past. He's got that experience over here as well, you know. He does understand the workings of this, which is why, again, he was, you know, brought down over here yesterday. He was, in fact, you know, in Mysuru City. He personally started to supervise this case, following which now in just about, 12 hours of his arrival over here now, a little less than, 24 hours of his arrival, beg your pardon. He's actually, they've managed to actually make four arrests. But yes, like you rightly said, there were a lot of questions that were building. Today is the fourth day since this incident took place, but the police have managed to nab four people. And the other two who were involved in this crime, you know, of course, the police currently not really sharing much information about them, but hopefully they will also be nabbed shortly is what we are picking up.
Mm-hmm. Neha, thank you for sharing all those details.